tied for second in Auburn High School season history. Clyde Pittman has played well, very well as of late. Now looking at the defensive line, Powell Gordon, one defensive end, Jimmy Vickerstaff, the other. Interior, Braden Jorder and Jemias Pitts are your interior linemen. They're going to have their hands full. Linebackers, Brad Harper with 8 tackles per game. Clark Cleveland at one outside linebacker. Coleman Granberry at the other. Looking at the defensive backs, your corners, Carson Yancey has 10 interceptions in his career. That is as he is approaching the record, which is 13, held by D. Finley. Nasir Pogue, your other cornerback, your safeties, Trey Elms and Kez Dooley. Those the defense is coordinated by Scott Goolsby. The offense coordinated by Will Wagnon. Those starting lineups brought to you by Auburn Bank, champions of you. And again, you are listening to the Russell Building Supply Countdown to Kickoff. Russell Building Supply and Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply. Experience some knowledge from the pros at your hometown home center. Now we'll look at what's going on in the region and in the area and in just in the local area. Last night, number 3 Central dominated Oxford to go 53-7 to finish the regular season undefeated. Number 9 Prattville is at Bob Jones tonight. Dothan plays McGill. Smith Station plays Stanhope Elmore. Jeff Davis last night got a win over Park Crossing to end their season with a win. And Enterprise is off this week as they prepare to go to Fairhope. Playoff matchups next week in the south part of 7A are Daphne at Central, Baker at Auburn, Enterprise is at Fairhope, and Prattville. Thank you.
tackles for tonight's game for IMG. Number 6, Cameron Linhart. Number 34, Jordan Hall. And number 54, Tyler Booker. For Auburn High, number 28, Camden Etheridge. Number 56, E.J. Harris. Number 74, Drew Bobo. And number 75, Braden Joyner. IMG is number 5, Malik Bryant. To start tonight's game, IMG will receive. Auburn High will kick and defend the south goal.
Southern Union. Also brought to you by Jeffcoat Trent, Auburn Bank, University Ace Hardware, and Gouge Performing Arts Center.
Auburn will be kicking off from left to right, going towards the Auburn Fieldhouse. IMG will be back deep to return. I am interested. They got 3 returners in other games that they have played. Ball into the end zone can be brought back here in Alabama. That is a dead ball.
I wasn't aware of that other high. I thought it was National Federation.
I just know I watched the game with a ball that was called in the end zone, and it was brought out of the end zone.
Well.
Owsley will kick off from left to right. And he got a good piece of it, and it will be about 4 yards deep. And IMG look like they're ready to go for the return, and they will take over at their own 20-yard line.
Well. I said at the beginning of the year, it's always good to start from the 20, so.
Here we go.
Here we go.
See what IMG wants to do. They are a spread team. Their quarterback is going to be A.J. Duffy, Florida State commit.
And they've asked to have the ball put on the left hash, their left hash, our right. So
6'2", 305, the quarterback. Ball is on the left hash where IMG wanted it. 2 receivers with an up back. Running back off to the right. For IMG, Auburn in a 4-3 look to start. Drop back, wants to curl. Auburn brings pressure, ball loose, ball picked off. Tigers have it at the 15-yard line, and Auburn has it in the red zone after one play.
Now, I have to admit, I was watching the receivers because I saw a matchup that I didn't like, so I don't know what happened.
Backside pressure. Powell Gordon knocked
Powell
it loose.
Gordon knocked it loose.
Clark Cleveland got the pick. Tigers have it first and 10. Auburn starts over inside the Byron Smokehouse red zone. Byron Smokehouse, an Auburn tradition for over 30 years.
Biggest thing you want to do, calm down.
Yes, sir.
We got a ball game. We got a play to run. That's one play. That's a great start.
Right.
And we get to get the second half kickoff, but a lot of ball to be played between now and then. They just jumped off sides with a hard
tackle.
Kick.
Jumps off sides. And
but like I said, here we got to calm down. We, the players do on the field, have to calm down. Fans go crazy, but players need to calm down.
Last time Auburn played what was thought about a top 10 nationally ranked team was Thompson last year in the state playoffs. Two receivers set. Pittman looks over now, and Auburn will shift over Daly. Etheridge and Leverett are go to a bunch set. Massey, your running back, and he flares out, now goes back in a little pop pass for Massey trying to get outside. I don't think this is that's the defense that you want to do to try to get outside on him. It's going to be a loss of about one on the pass.
Well, here's the thing. We had something at the beginning, but the corner came up and just destroyed the receiver and did exactly what he's supposed to do. We had the corner. I mean, we had the edge on the run, but the corner came up and just took it out.
So now we'll see what Auburn High wants to do here.
Trips lost a yard.
Yeah. Trips to the right side. IMG showing blitz off the left side. Davion now bounces to the left. Pittman drops back underneath. Got his receiver open for good yardage. Close to his first down yardage.
First down
inside the five as Pittman found the open receiver. I believe that one was VJ or might have been Bakari.
Well, they're locking up in man coverage. So you get those rub routes where the receivers cross each other and the defensive backs kind of run into each other trying to cover their man.
I believe that one was Bakari. Bakari on the catch. Gain of about 8 on the play. First and goal from the 3. Williams, your running back, off to the left. Now he'll go out, and now he'll come in return motion. And Auburn hands it up sides. Running hard is Davion Williams. He's going to be short of the goal line. Gets to the 1. Second down and 1 coming up.
Yeah, got to the 1. They're sending a bunch of heavy duties now.
Malik Bryant in on the catch. Auburn goes with their heavy set. They call this Beast. Well, here we go.
Beast against Beast.
You're right.
Because they sent in some meat. I saw some big guys come on and some little guys go off. So
they got a lot of big guys on that roster, Coach.
Yeah, they got big guys at every position.
Davion Williams, your running back, sends Bakari Daly in motion. And Auburn wants to throw it into
got
the
him.
End zone.
Touchdown.
Powell Gordon. Touchdown! Tigers lead.
I thought he bobbled it
for a second.
Hey, you know, overloaded it to the right. We've been showing this look all year long, and I keep going, why aren't we doing this to the left? But, you know, we're right-handed quarterback. But, we've been running out of this set, and then this was basically a tight end delay.
Yep.
And he basically blocked. The defense committed to the run, and he just slips out wide open. Touchdown, Auburn.
Tigers have a lead over IMG Academy.
Enjoy it, folks. Enjoy it.
I don't know if it was caught, but we'll take it. Snap, kick on the way is up. That kick is good. With 9:54, Tigers lead this one 7-0. We'll be right back. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
My joints aren't what they used to be. Routine exercise, playing ball outside with kids, riding bikes on vacation. I'm ready. Keeping it.
I decided
to make an appointment with the Orthopedic Clinic. Their surgical partners had the experience, technology, and personalized approach to care that I was looking for. Best of all, it was close to home. I'm thankful I chose the Orthopedic.
Number 9, Josh Owsley to kick for Auburn High. Deep to return for IMG. Number 88, Jalil Skinner.
Pick and Auburn High School punches it in to make it 7-0.
Yeah, if I'm, the coaches over there say, hey guys, they came to play. You better line up and, just don't take them lightly.
And Auburn, Josh Owsley will kick it 5 yards deep, and once again, it'll be at the 50 or the
20.
The 20-yard line, not the 50. for IMG. Well, there you go. What a start.
I would be surprised if they did anything but just run the ball this first play.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not sure that left tackle is used to that kind of speed coming off the edge either. And, you know, he
and
got
that
caught.
Was Powell going right again.
Yeah.
That's Auburn against Alabama there.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's made it personal, hasn't he?
Two back set here for IMG. Two receivers to the near side, one receiver to the top of the formation. Long snap count and just a little inside counter and breaking one tackle, breaking a second tackle in the open field. Here we go. At the 40, 45, 50, trying to bounce back. Big carry there for IMG, and that's Katron Allen, 5'11", 220. Auburn looked like they had the point of attack exactly where they wanted it, and then nice job of being patient by Allen. Makes the guy miss right at the line of scrimmage, and then boom, there you go.
He's their
40 yards later.
He's their strong physical running back. They got another one that's just a real slasher. He's a man child. He carries the ball with authority and stays behind his pads. He's hard to tackle.
Allen stays in at running back next to Duffy, the quarterback for IMG. He bounces now to the left side. Auburn shows blitz, and it's a handoff outside, and Allen with a good cut. He's going to get nine. Actually, no, they're going to say knee was down. They're going to give him eight on the play.
Just a handoff sweep. I mean, yeah. Outside zone, whatever you want to call it. A lot of times we call it outside zone today. It used to be what we call old Green Bay sweep,
yeah,
or buck sweep and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, you said it, Coach, right before this one. I'd be surprised if IMG, what's the easy way to settle down when you're on the road?
Hey, when you're a physical team like this, run the ball, it's tough to stop it.
Duffy in the gun for IMG. Claps the hands. And again, a little outside zone to the right side. Safety comes flying up, but it's going to be good yardage. It's going to be first down yardage. Gain of about 3 on second and 2. First down IMG.
And here again, it's just a sweep. But this time, the uncovered tackle, uncovered guard pulls. On the backside guard pulls, and they just got a bunch of bodies out there to contend with.
The other thing is what Auburn's able to do is they're able to get a guy to the play, but right now the IMG guy is just better than the Auburn guy. Three receivers to the near side for IMG. Allen stays in the backfield next to Duffy. Auburn shows blitz. And dropping back is Duffy. Auburn comes at it,
almost.
And Duffy breaks it contained into the open field. He's at the 10. And run out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Auburn brought pressure. It looked like they had a guy come free, but able to keep his presence was Duffy right up into the pocket, and a big gain down to about the 11-yard line, gain of 19.
Yeah, two guys coming off the edge, and they basically got blocked out into each other. But you got to realize when you're a linebacker coming through and you know you got edge pressure, you got to take the inside track, and he took the outside track, and it left it wide open for the quarterback to run the ball.
7:34 and counting left to go here in the first quarter. Auburn leads 7-0. IMG looking to answer. Jet motion here for Duffy. Inside zone. And Auburn, Brad Harper, able to meet the point of attack. It's going to be a gain of about 6 on the play, maybe 7, second goal.
Yeah, they just pulled the backside, the plug back pull, or the tight end. I don't know who you call that. He came around and inside zone with him blocking the defense, whoever the edge rusher is.
Split flow zone is what it's called a lot nowadays. Just let that backside tackle get to the next level. Under center here for IMG, just basic power up the middle. Auburn High School looked like they had the point of attack to stop it, and it's going to be in for the end zone. And right now, Allen, who you mentioned as their big, strong back, 5'11", 220, going to Penn State. That was all him all the time there.
Oh, yeah, and he was making plays. We were hitting him. I mean,
yeah,
we got folks banging on him, but he bangs back.
And all that started on the 40-yard run to start at Auburn High School. Had a guy there at the line of scrimmage to make the play. He just runs through the tackle, and there you go.
Well, we hit him here at the line of scrimmage, and
yeah,
he, just pushed through.
Extra point is on his way, is up and good. And just like that, IMG ties it up at 7. When we come back, Auburn High gets the kickoff. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
At South State, the focus is on the customer first. As your trusted financial partner, they're committed to providing more locations, enhanced products and services, and innovative digital banking technology to make your life easier and more convenient. With over 5,000 dedicated team members, South State is one of the leading regional banks in the Southeast, offering robust banking solutions, including consumer.
Jake Fleming to kick for IMG. Deep to return for Auburn High, number 7, Carson Yancey.
Of course, South Florida, they ain't used to, this kind
of. As that kick is not a great one, and it will be into the end zone. Yep.
Yeah, he kicked a low line driver, short hopped at about the 5 and went into the end zone. And on their kickoffs, they've been.
They've been in the back of the end zone.
They've been kicking it in the end zone, kicking it high and in the end zone every time on film. That's the first time I've seen them miss it.
So Auburn High School will now take over at their own 20-yard line.
And we got 6 minutes and 43 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
Two touchdowns and 6 minutes of action here. Auburn High School going with two tight ends, two receivers. Two receivers to the left side. Pittman into the game and wants a little quick throw. And got to be and that's the thing about that. Auburn made a nice play, nice read and all that. And VJ makes a nice catch, but the issue there is he even makes a nice move, but the guy grabs his shoe, and then there you go. Gain of 4 on the play.
Yeah, just a quick hitting pass because, you know, the thing is you don't want to give these defensive linemen too much time to get to your quarterback.
I think that's what Auburn High, something they put in this week was a lot of quick stuff, quick throws. Get the ball out of Clyde's hands, let him read it, react.
Well, you know, you got to give them formations where it's hard for them to walk up and play bump and run
like this bunch set.
They can't play bump and run against that.
Little bubble action to VJ into the front, open field, has first down to the 41, 42-yard line, first down Tigers.
Hey, great run after catching the ball. He drug two IMG players, defensive backs, probably 8 or 9 yards as he was making the break on the ball. And good blocking downfield by the other two receivers.
18-yard gain, 4-for-4 start for Clyde Pittman. And
they're calling timeout.
IMG's like, I don't like this bunch look. Let's call a timeout. 5:42 left to go here. Tigers and IMG tied at 7. We'll be back. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic. IMG wanted to make sure that they were all set up on that bunch look. Two tight ends, two receivers set here for Auburn High School. Williams, your running back next to Pittman. Claps his hands, and Auburn will now shift to that overload bunch set.
Unbalanced bunch. And see, IMG's not, they don't have enough people on this side.
Because
it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter if you're not able to block it. Loss of 2 on the play.
You know, I noticed that on film, they don't adjust to unbalanced and try to take advantage of it, but we just got whipped inside, number 19, just penetrated.
19, Dominic James, he's from Prattville, Alabama, as he was able to force the play.
I bet Prattville High School wish they had him.
I bet a lot of teams in this area wish they had him.
Same set to the other side, bunch over unbalanced.
Loss of 1 on the play. Play action for Pittman, and wants the out route to VJ. VJ has his catch, and it's going to bring up a third down and medium, gain of about four on the play.
I mean, you know, that was a catch bang. He caught it and got hit at the same time, and, you know, out of that bunch set. But I think it's a good plan of attack. You got to have something where you get rid of the ball quick. They're very strong up front. That, you know, I don't think they're going to bull rush over our two tackles.
Yeah.
But, you know, those guys are pretty good in the interior, and that's where our problems have been so far.
Bunch set, but it's a four receiver set to the near side, three to the near, one to the top. Pittman drops back and steps up. Now tries to get out of pressure, and he's going to get hit and sacked, and that'll be punting time for Auburn High School.
Closing speed. I'm going to tell you, that's the thing that you see, this the difference. These guys are explosive off the decision to make, you know, that it's a run.
Yep.
Once they realize it's a run, they're swarming.
Yep.
And that's what a good football team does.
They're good. Auburn High is showing go for it. I think what this is all about
probably
is
try to draw them off sides.
Well, no, you don't want to have them be able to return a punt, and Pittman doesn't hit a good one.
Yeah.
And it's going to be touchdown at about the 43-yard line.
We got a net of about 10 yards off that.
It's one of those things where you don't want to let them set up and have their return guy deep. But as soon as Auburn went to a punt look, they sent number two, Keon Sab, a Clemson commit, flying downfield.
Well, I ain't got no problem with a quick kick situation. Kick it.
Just don't miss it.
I'm of the opinion you always got to kick. If you're a right-footed kicker, kick toward the left, because you always run the risk of shanking it. I mean, you know, what do you call it? Fade? Hit a fade
to
the right. I'd rather hook it.
Taking over at the 43 now is IMG. Allen still the running back. Auburn High showing pressure. Allen now moves to the right. I feel like this was going to be a pass, just inside zone. Allen's going to get about four or five on the play. Didn't know where to line up, didn't matter. And that's just insert inside zone there. The offensive line got him about four on the play. Seven carries, 84 yards for IMG right now.
How much does number 11 for us weigh?
About 220.
Well, he looks like he's a stick compared to the rest of them.
Well, it's 220 against 320.
Yeah, 100 pounds difference. Yeah. He just looks small compared to them guys. All right,
inside,
just inside zone
once
again.
Again.
Good job.
Auburn High School had him, had
him
for a tackle for a loss. That's one heck of a spot.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to talk over you.
No, you're
I got
good.
Excited about it. It was a good
That's
good,
a nice
good
play.
Penetration defensively up front, and he just ran into the back of his offensive lineman. He's been getting off of that, but we held on, 25 held on, and swarming defense got on it. So it's third and about seven.
Clark Cleveland there with a tackle for a loss. That's number 10 on the year for him. For tackle for a loss. Also, he's got a pick on the night as well.
Boy, this left tackle's in the backfield.
Yeah, no, he's not close either.
Both of them have to be in the official's ear about that.
That is an NFL set right there. Auburn High School brings pressure. Duffy tries to run. He's going to have his first. There's a flag on the play. And Duffy is going to be to about the 30-yard line. That's either got to be a hold or it's got to be an illegal formation. And the chains have moved.
Well, they didn't know it. They just don't understand. But it's okay. I mean, I probably would have done the same thing. Yeah, it may be an illegal formation holding, but I'm going to tell you, those tackles, you got to have your shoulders in that area. Their heads are in the area.
His head's on the
backside.
That's
what I'm saying. Their shoulders have got to be on that hip area at least. I mean, that's something I would tell the – I mean, I'd be in his ear. I'm sure Coach would get into his ear, too.
I didn't know that you could stick out a ball at a defensive player in the middle of a play.
Well.
Third down and long, and this is where Auburn's been trying to get after Duffy. They've created some rush lanes, some scramble lanes.
Wait a minute, what was this?
A hold. It's from the spot of the foul.
Okay.
Third down and forever. Third down and a long.
25.
Yeah. Got it. Be alert for the vertical run here. Auburn High School shows pressure and drops back. Pitts showing pressure. Duffy throws it on the comeback. Incomplete. Tigers force a punt thanks to the hold. And it's with 2 minutes even left to go here. Auburn High School gets a stop on defense.
You know, great pressure from the backside, forcing the quarterback to run. He never could set up and throw. He had to throw. And the thing about it is you're a dead run, and you got to make a 25, 30-yard throw. That's not easy. And so he was running for his life, and incomplete pass.
Bakari Daly back deep for Auburn High School, averaging about 14 yards per punt return on the day.
Hadn't seen them punt much, so I know he's probably a good punter. Just hadn't seen much of it on film.
We're assuming he's a good punter. End-over-end kick, and Bakari's going to take it. He's going to make a guy miss. Up the other side. He's at the 40. Cuts back. He's at the 45. And now going the other way at the 40, 35. And hello speed from IMG, but good field position for Auburn High School at the 32-yard line.
Great return. The thing that I really liked toward the end of that run, he had the presence of mind to put that ball in his left hand so that defender, he wasn't on the side where the tackler was coming. That was a great return and a good field position for Auburn at the 33-yard line, 33-yard line.
Second out of three possessions that Auburn High School has had the ball in IMG territory. First and 10 at the 32-yard line going in from the far hash.
Well, we had a great wall, too, on this kill, that punt.
That bunch overload set once again to the short side of the field now. Pittman drops back and flushed and tries to break a tackle and was going to be held up. And, Coach, what you saw there was the defensive players holding up Pittman and then trying to get the football out of there.
Well, the first guy that got to him got nothing but a shirt sleeve, but he didn't let go.
He didn't let go.
And then the rest of them were able to get him. This is second and 15 now. We actually had a guy open initially right on that wheel right out of that bunch if we could have got it off quick. But he was looking – he was staring too much white shirt, white helmet in his face.
Yeah, well, it was a – even though there might have been a hat on a hat, there was some push behind the hat on the defensive side. Pittman has it, and Auburn wants the bubble once again. And Auburn, when you run that one, you got to hit all your blocks. Gain of two, third down and long coming up.
I tell you what, the closing speed is pretty impressive.
Yeah.
And I think Auburn High School has good closing speed.
Yeah.
And these guys have it at another level.
Something else.
We hadn't seen this kind of speed on defense.
Coach, I don't know if there's a high school team that has this type of speed on defense.
Well, if they're number two in the country, I sure don't want to play number one.
Well, that Mater Dei team out in California is pretty darn good.
Have they played this bunch?
A couple of years ago, last time they played.
Well, they ought to play each other.
I agree.
Got 21 seconds to go in the quarter.
18 seconds and counting. Auburn High going on some motions. Here comes Etheridge. Play action going to the boot. Stepping up is Pittman, now looking to run out. He's at the 30, and he's going to get hit and flung out of bounds. There's nothing wrong with that play. It was in the field of play.
No, I have no problem. He kind of slung him at the end, but that I have no problem. He's throwing him out of bounds. Yeah. It's better than going to the ground with him.
I agree. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Tigers gain yardage, but it's still going to be a fourth down and about six coming up here to start the second quarter. 7-7 our score. We are tied. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic. High School on to attempt the field goal from 45 yards out. Ball's on the right hash. Snap and low kick, and it is
good.
Wow.
11:55 left. Owsley mishit that
he
one.
He missed it. Yeah. When they first hit it, I thought that thing was going to be way short, down low. But it got through. Line drive went right over the goalpost. Great job. Auburn High has the lead for the second time tonight.
Auburn High has a lead in the second quarter. So as we have this second, let's take a look at some scores. Brought to you by Franklin Tire and Auto. 7-0 Prattville over Bob Jones. 7-3 Dothan over McGill. Huh? That's weird. 14-7 Theodore over Mary Montgomery. And no score bottom of the first between the Braves and the Astros. Those scores brought to you by Franklin Tire and Auto. Friendly service from Franklin on East University Drive across from CC's Pizza in Auburn. Imagine if Dothan pulls off that upset, a team that has done very little all year long, and they're able to knock off McGill Tulum. Well, Coach, it was, you know, come out, play well early, and see what happens.
Well, hey, you know, it's been fun so far.
It has
been
fun.
We said let's go out and have fun. They're having fun. Looks like our guys are having fun.
Hey, it's also Halloween weekend.
Hey,
look, spooky season.
Here we go. I'm going to tell you, look at the crowd behind IMG. I mean, I know it's
a lot of local people.
A lot of local people, a lot of opponents, other schools, and we kicked it out of bounds.
Owsley kicks it out of bounds. And you know what? That's been the book on Josh here this year. When he's made a big field goal, he's so amped up, he ends up kicking it out of bounds. Unfortunately, IMG is going to have really good field position.
Yeah, that's 15 yards better than what they normally would get.
Hey, but the last time they took over at the 43 and Auburn High School was able to force a punt. Oh, no. IMG's so good on the kick return, we're re-kicking.
Yeah.
Well, here's the other thing is Owsley can kick this one deep enough, but now you're worried with the amount of athletes that IMG has returning the ball that trouble could be afoot.
Well, maybe settle down a little bit now and hit it like it needs to be hit.
Is that 88 or is that 81 down there? It's a tight end back deep. That's not something you see every day. Sean Miller also back deep, as well as number 24, Kamari Wilson. Kamari Wilson, a five-star recruit. For Auburn High School, we'll tee this one up from the 35. Here comes Owsley on the approach. He'll boot it away, and that one also goes into the cheerleaders.
Huh.
I like this is.
Well, when he hit it weird. I saw it when he hit it. It flubbed it. I don't know. This is not very uncharacteristic.
No, those are the worst two. Like that one was the worst one I've seen
this
him
year.
Hit all year.
This year, by far.
See what IMG wants to do.
Oh, they go. Yeah. You're darn right. They go kick it again.
Well, it looks like they're pulling them off. So now they might be taking it at about the 40.
They're going to take it. Well, I was wrong. Because they'll get it on the 40-yard line.
Where are they putting it at?
They get it on the 40. Not a bad start to bottom of the kickoff.
Two bad kicks, and it's 20 yards of field position for IMG.
My policy usually was don't say anything to the kicker.
He'll figure it out.
He'll figure it out. I mean, he kicks
and again,
more than
like,
I have.
Josh has been really, really good this
consistent.
Year.
He's been consistent. I mean,
he hits a big field goal, and then he's just amped up, and then he has a bad hit. It happens. Three receivers to the far side for IMG, a tight end to the near side for Duffy. Allen still your running back for IMG. Tackles kind of sort of close to where they're supposed
right
to be.
Here off on our left, their right side.
7 seconds left to go. And there's a little trap right up the middle for Allen. Bounces it outside. Going to get a gain of about 5 on the play, maybe 6. Same side trap play. And that's an interesting design there.
Well, you know, the thing is, you know, it was a counter move. He started to the left like inside zone to our left and then their right. And then he cut it back, planted his foot and cut it back on the trap. Hey, you know, the thing is, great closing speed. Auburn's all over the ball and they get 6 yards out of it.
The other thing is your first guy didn't whiff. He at least stood him up and gave teammates a chance.
But, you know, he still got 6 yards on a first down play.
Coach, sometimes you just got to take 6 and be happy.
Take it and happy, yeah.
Two receivers to the top of the formation, run right behind the two, and Allen almost slips through. He's into Auburn territory, and a shoestring tackle saves the touchdown to the 41-yard line.
Just a good old buck sweep right there is all that was.
Gain of 13 on the play.
Just like they drew it up on paper.
It's not good if you're a defensive guy if it works just like the offense wanted to draw it up. It usually means they're going to have a blocker and on everybody and a running back right up the middle. Empty set here for IMG. I would call a quarterback draw or a slant. That'll work too.
Touchdown.
Missing a tackle.
Dang,
at the 25, at the 20. Closing speed for Auburn High School. Knocks out the receiver. But moving into the red zone, brought to you by Byron Smokehouse Breakfast, is IMG.
I didn't think we'd get him because it was 13 out there.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's the bull rush guy. He's the bruiser. You see him right there knocking three or four of our guys down. I really thought he'd score, but shows you what I know. Ball's on the 16-yard line.
16-yard line. Gain of 26. First completion for IMG. 1 for 3 on the night for 26 yards.
Tell you what was impressive, too, the quick release of the quarterback. He got that ball, got rid of it quick.
There's a reason he's going to Florida State. 5 seconds left to go on the play clock. Duffy, just an inside. No, he keeps it.
He kept
out
it.
The right side, out the left side, and it's a touchdown. I'll say this about A.J. Duffy.
He's a hot dog.
He does not lack for confidence, and if he would have
done.
No,
he's a hot dog.
If he would have done what he just did in a college game, the touchdown would not have counted.
Ought to have been a yellow flag for this one.
Yeah, I'm surprised it wasn't, to be honest with you. Gain of 16 in the touchdown, and IMG takes their first lead of the game.
Hey, act like you've done it before. Block the extra point.
Extra point is blocked, so that's just going to be no good. Cannot return it. 13-10, our score here. With 9:57 left to go in Auburn High School, we come back from this break. We'll take over. This time, for the first time, they're going to be down here against IMG. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network, presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
Supply is Auburn's hometown home center. With top brands and an easy-to-use drive-through lumber yard, we have what you need to get the job done. Register for great in-store giveaways. Russell Building Supply, East University Drive in Auburn.
Experience and knowledge from the pros. Russell Do It Center at Building Supply.
Classic hits and Auburn High School football. Wings 94.3.
Welcome back to Auburn, Alabama here as IMG has taken a lead for the first time, 13-10, your score here in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a good fake by the quarterback, and hey, there was nobody around. No. He could have
zone read, and Auburn's
zone
been
read.
Very
we
aggressive
and
to try to get to Allen to slow him down, and Duffy's shown – right now, his biggest impact on the game has been with his legs.
Yeah, he's gotten a couple first downs with his legs. He's got this touchdown with his leg. I mean, there's no doubt he's an outstanding athlete.
Yep.
I just don't like that kind of stuff, period.
And what he did was he pulled up. You know what? If you pull up and jog into the end zone, whatever. But he pulled up and jogged and then hailed.
And turned and bailed, backpedaled, and kind of
hailed the ball
like,
out to the closest. Yeah.
You know, I just don't. I mean, I just don't care for that kind of stuff.
Also, how normally if
well,
you know,
here's the
if
thing.
A kid gets upset, then all of a sudden he takes
it's
a cheap shot.
It's disrespectful to
yeah.
your opponent. That's yeah. all I say. That's just showing disrespect and disdain for your opponent. I don't like that kind of stuff. I hope he doesn't do it anymore. And he's probably a fine young man, but I don't like that kind of stuff.
Inside zone for Davion Williams. Can't bounce it outside against this crew. No gain on the play. And that's going to be a loss of – actually, it's going to be a loss of one. And that play right there is something that Auburn High that hurt Auburn High against Central when they tried to run it in and you have the outside guy that's blocking out, he's not going to be able to help you hook that guy. Got to get vertical. Three receivers to the top of
unbalanced.
The formation. Auburn back in that unbalanced bunch set, and now Auburn's flipping the formation.
And now it's unbalanced to this side.
Yep.
Unbalanced, almost a bunch, not quite.
Pittman drops back. immediate pressure, looking for help, finds Etheridge. First down yardage for Cam Etheridge, and he's going to be tackled out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. Nice pickup there, gain of 20 on the play.
It's a flag.
Roughing the passer. We're going 15 yards on the addition of the 20-yard pass.
Yeah, good job by the quarterback getting free on that because they had him.
Yeah.
And he got free, rolled to his right, found Etheridge, you know, on the crossing route, and a great play by him. Then he got roughed by the defensive lineman.
Gain of 20 on the play. And Auburn High School moves inside the Auburn or inside IMG territory.
They're at the 46-yard line.
2x2 set here for Auburn. Auburn goes hard count. I don't know how IMG lines up that close to the ball, and they don't jump. Auburn now puts a tight end attached. Outside zone, Davion puts his foot in the ground. There's a better run that time. Gain to about the 41, gain of about 5.
That's that right behind our big boys, too, right there behind Bobo and Avery.
Pulled two around as well.
With Etheridge blocking it tight end. Did a pretty good job on number 34 there. Good block.
That was GT. You had Eric Patrick wrapping around and E.J. Harris.
So that's a good job, a second and 5.
Sets up second and manageable.
Shoot, I run it again. If at first you succeed, yeah. Do it again.
Two receivers to the near side. Two receivers stacked to the right. And now here comes Daly in motion. Dropping back is Pittman.
Got him.
They want Davion. Davion open. First down yardage to the 20, to about the 31-yard line. I am hoping this is just a sideline warning on Auburn High School.
Well, it ain't holding, so I don't know what it is.
Chains moved again.
Well, what they did, they overloaded it, and then they're trying to play that matchup man coverage. So we're pushing those guys off and bringing the back out of the backfield, which they're not. They don't have. They got to ask a linebacker to come from inside out to make
Auburn's
this play.
Auburn's going to get called for an illegal downfield, and the Auburn coaches are infuriated right now because they asked and they asked and they asked and they said, and what you see an Auburn High School player doing is said, I said I was off. And normally, if that's not the case, you're going to get a response from the official that says he was off, he was on, something like that.
Hell, the White has fixed it. He's coming. He's probably telling coach to calm down a little bit. I don't blame him.
Yeah, but the issue there is you have a really good play call that's taken back because of something that they feel wasn't the correct call.
Well, typically you do communicate with the official. He communicates back. There was a time when they would say, you know, we can't do that anymore, but now they've come back, you know, to it and try to do a better job of just communicating because, kid, it's hard to tell sometimes when you're way out there, and that official's got a good viewpoint from it. So, you know, hopefully they'll do a little bit better job with the
Well, here's the other issue. We've got to get the chains reset where they were supposed to be at because it was 2nd and 5.
They got that little clip they put on the chain every time. So
yeah, but everybody had already moved down.
Yeah, but that clip will save them. They don't move that clip until after the ball snap, supposedly. You don't move that. You got a clip on the chain for where the ball was. You put that back. As long as you got that on there, it's got a little indicator
on there.
This
should. No, this should be 2nd and 10.
Well, it depends on the call. They call us for illegal formation?
They haven't made the call yet. But you had a 5-yard gain. And then you had it's 2nd down and 10. It's not 1st down and 15. Or not 1st down, whatever the heck this is.
Something's not right. They got to move the chains, and they're still getting them adjusted. So it's 1st and 15, according to the chains.
That's a wrong call.
And eligible downfield. No, okay, they've got it right now. But is it 3rd or 2nd?
It wasn't 2nd and 10.
What down was it? It was 2nd. I forget what down it was.
It was 2nd and 5 after the run.
So it should be 2nd and 15.
2nd and 10. Because they called an illegal formation, which is a 5-yard penalty, makes it 2nd and 10. No, I don't. Even illegal downfield is a 5-yard penalty.
Looks like they gave us the first down and then assessed the penalty afterwards. But if it was an illegal formation or ineligible downfield, it should come back.
It's a 5-yard penalty. It's original spot and it's 2nd down. We'll take a break as we don't know what's going on. Neither do the officials. We'll be back. 8:03 left to go here. Tigers Down by three. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic. Tell you what,
we still got some confusion.
Yeah, it's first and 15 somehow on second and five play.
Got 10 seconds left to get the playoff. We had some confusion on the offensive formation.
Yeah. Pittman drops back, wants the screen to the near
good
side
call.
To
good
Davion.
Call.
Davion cups back, makes one guy miss, and gets smashed. He's going to get down to the 35-yard line. Gain of 10, third down and about four or five.
Great offensive selection here. I mean, great call. I mean, there's a screen. IMG, they're screaming.
Yeah.
And they're getting through as usual, but they don't realize it's a screen. And they read it, saw it too late. Yeah, just great job. Good blocking downfield, too. Second and five.
Second down and five. Now they give them 11, second and four on the play. Auburn pulls a couple. Davion tries to pull it right up in there, but backside defensive lineman was there to cover it up. No gain.
Yeah, somebody,
maybe lost one. Third down coming
somebody
up.
Somebody missed the lineman, the defensive lineman, and he came off the thing from behind and got it. I mean, it was a good play by him. Oh, that's a linebacker, wasn't it? Yes,
yeah,
linebacker. The backside linebacker.
Backside. The guy who you normally don't account for in the run game ends up making the
backside
play.
Backside linebacker. Well, a lot of times those guys, when you have big plays, it's because they overrun the play. Well, he didn't. He ran right where he's supposed to. We didn't get anything out of it.
6:50 and counting left to go here. Third down and about five. Three receivers to the right. Pittman has it, drops back, and wants to drag to the near side, has Daly. First down yardage. Makes one guy miss, makes a second guy miss. There's going to be a flag on the play, and I believe it's either going to be a hold or a face mask.
I think it might be inadvertent face mask, the 5-yard penalty type. I could be wrong, but that's what it looked like to me. I thought I saw a hand go over his face.
I want to know this. If you're the officials, it's time to get control of the game. You have – there should have been another flag. You have an IMG player literally pointing directly at the Auburn bench.
Face mask.
Face mask on Auburn Heights, on IMG rather. First down yardage to the 25, gain of about 11 on the play, plus the additional penalty yards.
I have a hard time criticizing the officials. I did it enough for 42 years. I don't need to do it now.
But so it'll be half the distance from the from the 25-yard line.
I don't know that I would have. I don't know that I saw a 15-yard face mask. I saw a 5-yard face mask. It was just a grab of the face. His head went down a little bit. His chin went down to his chest while the guy was tackling. Those are two great offensive
really good play calls right there
by the coaches right
Auburn
here.
Auburn High School moves into the red zone. Brought to you by Byron Smokehouse Breakfast.
Uh-oh.
Flag on the play.
They got too many men on the field.
Somebody's got too many something.
I think they got 12.
Let's count them up.
They got 12. They got 12.
Illegal on IMG.
They got 12 on the field. Yeah, that's good. When that guy throws a flag before the ball set, that's too many men on the field.
Well, here's the deal. Nobody's run off for IMG.
They haven't brought anybody off yet. You want to get another one? We'll take it.
IMG calls the timeout, and now everybody's upset. .626 left to go here. IMG leads Auburn 13-10. Auburn has it at the 10-yard line, about the 5-yard line, 6-yard line, looking to retake the lead. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
Thank you.
It's first down and five from the six. Auburn High School can get a first down inside the 2 yard line. Two receiver set, two tight ends. Hand off to Davion Williams, and he's going to get stuffed at about the 5 yard line. And now he will get stood up and driven back. And gain of one on the play, second down about
four.
Gain
of one, you know, I thought we had a little something. He stuck his foot in the ground and cut back, and I thought we had something, but it closed real fast.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think it was one of those things where Auburn High had a guy covered up that they were blocking, and he just came loose at the last second. Might be a situation right here where you go maybe tight, play action, get a little boot going, something like that.
They're still in that too high safety, high look.
Yeah.
So they're bumping run coverage.
Play action. Pittman puts his foot in the ground, trying to get into the end zone, gets hit.
Ooh,
and he's going to be short to the one. Should be a first down,
should
though.
Be a first down.
So it should be first and goal from the 1 yard line. Great run there by Clyde Pittman. Puts his foot in the ground, runs hard. These safeties, when they come up, they come low.
They come up, put you in the hospital.
Yeah.
They first down, so it's first and goal at about the foot line. I mean, he got hit right at the goal line, but they swarmed the ball. I mean, they closed real fast.
Auburn High going beast, I believe. 13 seconds left to go on the play clock. Auburn's in their B set. Need to get set up, though, with 8 seconds.
Five seconds now. Well, he saw it.
Did somebody finally see it?
Well, this back judge over here on our sideline saw it, but I don't know why
the line judge didn't.
Well, he couldn't see it. He wouldn't see the coaches. I mean, that's one of them cases where the coach runs down there and takes his shirt off and waves and screams, timeout. Yeah. You get on the 10-yard line and you're looking at him. You know, you're on the field. Like almost like you're going to get a penalty for it just to get their attention sometimes.
Yeah. As there's 4:54 left to go here.
So what you had, we had a quarterback not in the game.
Yeah, Auburn went with their B set.
That was with a wildcat type
yes,
set.
Sir.
So he wasn't aware of the clock like a normal quarterback would be.
Yeah, DV's not. And, you know, that's just not. And that's
okay. That's a good timeout to take right there. Plus two. You get a chance to see how they lined up against it.
You already seen it, so now you get to see maybe see what you like out of it and everything else. 4:54 left to go here. Tigers down three, but it's first and goal at the one.
You got four downs. I mean, it ain't at the one. It's at the inch line. I mean, the ball is clearly inside the 1 yard line. And the ball is almost touching the goal line. I mean, this is one of them things where you just want to take it with the shotgun and just go airborne.
Well, we'll see what DV does. Oh. Auburn goes under center with Braden Jordan. They sneak it for the touchdown.
Now, describe how big this young man is.
Braden Joyner is 6'2", 310 pounds. He was the up back. He moved to the quarterback, took the snap. Quarterback sneak for the touchdown.
Quarterback sneak. That's a lot of meat going behind meat.
So,
meat behind meat.
Yes, sir. 4:51 left to go. A 1 yard touchdown plunge from Braden Joyner to give Auburn the lead once again.
16-13. Kick the extra point. 17-13.
Owsley on to attempt the extra point. Kick is on the way. Is up, and that kick is good. 4:51 left to go here. Tigers lead IMG 17-13. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic. Franklin Tire and Auto.
Thank you.
Number 9, Josh Owsley to kick for Auburn High. Deep to return for IMG.
And it was held by a penalty. It held by a face mask, but, you know.
It was a first down either way. And Auburn, also Auburn overcame some adversity, that weirdness with the penalty.
Yeah, that worked, turned out to okay, but
yeah.
Still, that was a little dodd.
We'll see Owsley put this one in the end zone, and they fight over it, and it will be taken at the goal line up the middle. Uh-oh, touchdown.
Nope, not yet.
Owsley.
Don't give it to him yet.
Back at the 50, going back the other way.
Got him.
And yeah, you're right. Good job by the Auburn defense and the Auburn coverage unit to get down there to him. But I think this ball went to the end zone.
They
Coach, that ball's in the end zone. Yeah, they caught it in the end zone.
They caught it, but one of them bumped the other one into the end zone, so I don't know how the rule is on that. If you knock your teammate in the end zone, he did. The ball looked like it penetrated the back of the goal line, though.
That ball was in the end zone. Auburn High just got a sideline. Auburn High just got a penalty.
Well, not a penalty, sideline warning.
Yeah, Auburn got a sideline warning.
It's not going to be
because there. Auburn is fighting over what it amounts to, should be at the 20-yard line, and right now IMG is about to snap the ball from the Auburn 31.
The 50-yard difference there.
Yep.
All right, I guess they get writing down what they got and setting the chains.
Yeah.
Got 4 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the first half. Auburn's up 17-13 over IMG. I ain't gonna lie, I'm kind of surprised.
Auburn's come out and they've played really, really well.
I thought Auburn would have a good show,
yeah,
especially early in the game. But this late in the half, I mean, I'm really pleased.
Got to give you confidence for anybody. You got to play the rest of the way.
Absolutely.
Two
backs in the backfield, gun split.
Yeah, two backs set here. Two receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Two receivers are the wide side of the field. Duffy drops back, and it's going to be a false start.
No, I think we penetrated. Or
was it offsides?
Offsides.
Well, considering we got a D lineman coming off, yeah, that's a safe bet. Second down and five. Or first down and five, rather. Same. IMG looked like they want to take a shot there.
Same formation, twin split.
Auburn High showing pressure. Here they come. Duffy drops back, wants the post route, and incomplete. Carson Yancey there, stride for stride. Looked like that was a bit of an option route, as the receiver looked like he wanted to run the post, and the quarterback threw the go.
Well, I was watching the pressure.
Yeah.
We got to him, but we getting to him at his ankles. We weren't up in his face. We were going down as we were getting pressure.
That's legal in this level. Wing back set for IMG. Two receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Duffy has it. Little inside read.
Oh.
And Powell Gordon swallows him up. And it's going to be no gain on the play.
Yeah, it was that trap where the back comes across, but the guy was supposed to block Powell, didn't block him.
Nope.
The linebacker stepped up. It got the back confused. Well, the back didn't block anybody.
Yeah.
So Powell was able to hit him in the mouth.
And I don't know if that was something that what a lot of teams do after they run that split flow action, they'll then RPO it with the guy in the flat.
Yeah, they got that big bulldozer in there.
Yeah. Third and six here for IMG. Two back set once again.
Look for him to do something to the inside receiver up top because he's got a lot of cushion there.
5 seconds to go on the play clock. 3, 2, triple option. Keeping it is Duffy. He's going to be short. Fourth down and about 5.
Oh, he only gained about a yard and a half, 2 yards. We had a linebacker scraping over the top, hit him good. Power Gordon and the linebacker both made that play. So Power, he squeezed. The ball, the carrier went up, faked up inside. He got off that look and helped get on the quarterback. They're going to go for it, fourth and about four.
Why not go for it right now? 3:13 left to go. Auburn leads by a score of 17-13. Three receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. And now IMG will go empty.
Looks like we got a little bit of confusion in the secondary here for some reason.
Time.
Well.
2-1. IMG has it. They drop back. They want the slant. Backed away. Incomplete. Great play. And the Tigers get a stop with 2:50 left to go.
What a great break on the ball by number four. They tried to throw a stopper out. Basically, it was going to be enough for the first down. And then he just came up and hit it, and hit it right through the guy's elbow, knocked the ball loose. Boom, right there.
I see your Pogue. Read it and drove on it, knocked it away. Tigers get a stop.
Great job. What a way. I mean, we've got 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Now, let's take this thing. Be patient, but let's see what we can do with it. Two tights, two flankers.
Pittman in the gun. Inside handoff on the zone read. Ooh, up the middle.
Almost
popped it through there.
Yeah, inside zone up the middle, and just one guy got a shoestring and drug him down barely.
Let's see. I think that was – is that Brad?
All right, second down.
Yeah, Brad Harper on the carry.
Second and two. 2 minutes and 25 seconds till halftime.
Two receivers to the near side, and a two tight end set once again. Pittman moves the back to the right. That's Harper. Again, handoff into Harper. Harper with a nice cut. Should have close to his line to gain, and it's a first down.
First down by a couple yards. Good job. The clock is stopped while they reset the chains at 2 minutes and 12 seconds.
Two 12 and counting. Auburn High School, it's a situation where you get the ball. You'd want to make sure that though it's that clock's not running yet. It's about to start. There it goes. You want to make sure IMG doesn't get the ball back here.
Yes. Two tights, two flankers again.
Harper moves to the right. Hand off inside once again. Up the middle. Got good yardage. Gain of nine. Safeties are sure tacklers here for IMG. Number two, Keon Sab. A Clemson commit stepped up to make the play there. That's a great job of blocking right there.
That left side of our line just wiped it out. I mean, took IMG's defensive front and just took him in the linebacker's lap, and that's why the linebacker wasn't there. Yep. He was entertaining a defensive lineman getting hit his lap.
You had the wash down by the left side, and then you had the right side wrapping around on the GT action. A lot of bodies going in the right way that you want for Auburn High School there.
The guy that had to make the play was a safety.
Yeah. Second down and about 1:20 and counting. Auburn High School being very patient here on this drive.
Ooh, he's almost offside, isn't he?
Davion Williams has his first, and going to be down into IMG territory with a minute and eight left.
Got a first down, so the clock stops. Now it's running again. Well, they just held it a while ago and reset the chains.
Yeah, now they're letting it go in a hurry.
I don't understand.
Under a minute now left to go, 53 and counting. Tigers got to go. Pittman in the gun from the ING 49. Inside to Williams. Williams run hard, has his first, should be close to his first down. It's going to be the first down. Tigers have one timeout left. Auburn trying to sub. Now they're going to say run it. They're going to say he was short. Tigers got to go. No, they're going to give it to him. 32.9 left to go, 30 seconds. Now left to go here in the first half. Pittman claps his hands and drops back. Looks over the middle. Now looking for the corner out. Picked. Underthrew it. Was looking for Cam Etheridge. And going to be a tackle there at the 45-yard line. There's going to be, I believe, there's a flag down here. I'm not sure who it's on. I don't know what Clyde was looking at, but it looked like he wanted the corner route.
It was a corner route.
But there was miscommunication
on
where the ball was thrown.
Way underthrown.
As there is a flag on the play, and that's going to be after the – it should be after
it'll
the –
it'll be holding on them, so it'll be during the play, so it'll bring it back.
Well, if it's during the play, it's still Auburn ball. If it's after the change of possession,
it's
IMG.
Change of possession.
Yeah, it's going to be IMG ball. So with 13.4 left to go here, IMG will take over deep in their own territory.
So ball's going to be somewhere around the 20-yard line.
Yep. At about the 22, 13.4 left to go here. in the first half.
All right, IMG's still in the huddle on the sideline.
Yeah, I know. I'm surprised that we don't have – well, the clock is going. Is IMG going to take a shot? You don't take that long to take a knee.
They're going to call a timeout.
Well, IMG, they took a shot. They're taking a shot here, and I don't know with the amount of talent they got.
I'm going to tell you, my experience is when you take a shot like this, if the other team picks it off and gets a decent return, if you got enough time, you can time out and get a field goal. That's what I mean.
We saw Jeff. It happened with Jeff Davis. Auburn came around, got a strip sack, and then a field goal right there. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
WGZZ, Waverly, Auburn, Opelika, a broadcast service of Auburn Network Incorporated. Your Auburn High School football station. Wings 94-3.
Welcome back to Auburn, Alabama. Duck Samford Stadium here. Auburn High School leads IMG 17-13 here.
All right, IMG's lined up.
Yeah, they're going to take a shot here. 2-by-2 set, and there's a lot of space here. As Auburn High is in prevent defense.
Well, you give it to them. Let them have it in front. But these guys are so athletic.
You
got to
tackle.
You got to make tackles.
Slant into the open field. There's your tackle with 41, or at the 41, or the 42-yard line. 6.6 left to go. No timeouts for IMG.
Just don't give up. Put some good
pressure
on.
4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. And they somehow got it off. And Duffy wants a little out route, and they're going to step out of bounds. And Auburn High School is going to go to the locker room with the lead over the number 2 team in the country. Your score at half, 17-13, Auburn High School leads. As it's been one heck of a game. Auburn High School's made some plays. IMG has made some plays as well.
Auburn High's got a lot of breaks that you got to have.
Yep.
I mean, you got to have. If you're going to play somebody like this, you got to have some breaks. So the opening play, the fumble, and we got it in great field position, stuck it in, had the great kickoff return or punt return after the ball got low, you know, it was a bad punt by them, and, you know, rolled on the ground. We scoop it up and take it back for a big play and get great field position, score off of that. You know, just some good things have happened to Auburn. That's got to happen when you play a team like this. You got to have good things. Had a couple of penalties by IMG.
The other thing is there's Auburn's running the ball here.
And having
tonight.
Some success running the ball, which is, you know, I felt like that's been something I've been looking forward to seeing.
Well, the biggest carryover to me from this game, win, lose, or draw, is Auburn High School is running the ball against this front. If they want to do it again in three, if they want to win a state championship, they got to do it again against Central. They got to do it against Thompson or Hoover.
Well,
you could do it against them cats. You can do it against those cats.
You might as well face it. You're making a statement here. Nobody in the playoffs going to take you lightly
at
this point.
I think after last year, nobody was taking you.
You just put a big target on yourself just by this first half performance.
Well, I'd rather have a target than
– Listen, it's a lot more fun than being the target than it is shooting at the target.
That's true.
That sounds crazy, but when the game of high school football, you want to be the guy everybody wants to be.
We come back, we're going to have the halftime report. Auburn High School leads IMG 17-13. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
That's true. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Dr. Kristen Herring, Superintendent of Auburn City Schools, and Dr. Shannon Pignato, Principal of Auburn High School, we welcome you again to Duck Samford Stadium, home of your Auburn High School Tigers. And now, for your halftime entertainment, under the direction of AHS Director of Bands, Miss Deanna Marshall, we present the award-winning Auburn High School Marching Band. This year, the band has already received numerous accolades and awards as a part of their annual competitive season, including straight superior ratings in all categories, best-in-class majorettes, best-in-class percussion, most outstanding soloists, and two-time best-in-class drum majors. We continue our competitive season tomorrow at the Super Bowl of Sound competition in Carrollton, Georgia. Tonight, we invite you into the shadows as we once again accept our mission, decipher the secret code, and do the impossible. The Auburn High School Marching Band is proud to present our 2021 production, Codename. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Cole Brady, Sydney Hamilton, Hannah Herring, and Joshua Thomas. Drum majors, is the band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Auburn High School Marching Band. Ladies and gentlemen, the Auburn High School Marching Band. Please be sure to visit the Auburn Band Parents Association concession stand this evening. All proceeds from the concession stand go to support the band programs of Auburn City Schools at Auburn High School, Auburn Junior High School, and the East Samford School. Hot Chick-fil-A sandwiches are waiting for you there.
Attention, please, Kimela Motley. Kimela Motley, please come to the press box. Thank you.
So, yeah, you get a chance. I mean, get a chance to take that momentum and bring it into the third quarter. The one thing you don't want to have happen is something, you know, silly. You know, turnover or something like that. But IMG typically, when they kick off, their guy puts it in the back of the end zone. So, you know, our guy does too, and he kicked two out of bounds. So, who knows? You never know what's going to happen.
And then hit one just short of the goal line, maybe. And then it was a big return for IMG.
But we stopped them.
We stopped them.
So,
and also give credit to Owsley. To force
made the guy cut back inside
and then everybody else did their job and got back.
All right, well, we're about to kick off here.
Toe meets leather, and that one will be about 4 yards deep, and Auburn High will take over at the 20.
All right, let's see what we're going to do in this half.
Run the football.
Yeah, that'd be good.
If you're able to do
the thing about it is we had some pretty good success right there. Now, you know, they may have been playing a little bit looser, you know, just thinking it was going to be, you know, passing situation. I don't know.
But two rushing touchdowns, Auburn's had to run it in the red zone. They've done that.
Yeah, but that one of them was a 330-pound.
It counts.
That counts. Yeah, it does. it's a run. It's a foot touchdown. I can't argue with that.
Two receivers to the near side with two tight ends in the game as well. Massey moves to the right side of Pittman. Pittman, play action, now needs some help and throws it, and it's going to just throw it away. Looked like a little RPO there.
Well, you know, it was supposed to be a real quick pass to our receivers, but we were up in press. They were up in press man in our face and wasn't letting us off.
Yeah.
We just wasn't getting off.
I think that one was one of the RPOs that Auburn likes to run. The issue with the RPO is press man kind of kills the RPO.
Yeah, there's no – yeah. You can't
get off of it.
You got to run a rub route. You got to do something to displace that. Two tights, two flankers this time.
Press coverage again.
Again, I think they're going to do what they do best.
Press coverage, and Auburn's got to run the ball against that look. Going to get about four on the play, bring up a third down and about six.
Yeah, just straight inside zone right there, nothing fancy. Right over our left side, right over Avery's rear end.
Right over, Avery and Bobo. Third and six coming.
Yeah, they're getting that press man. The only thing about that is you start running rub routes. Just depends on how good the safety is then, because he's got to pick up the mess. Looks like they'll bring a corner outside linebacker, whoever's covering inside. Well, I don't know what they're doing now.
Auburn's flipping around. Two tight end set with the two flanker. Press coverage once again.
Look for some edge pressure right here. Yep, there you come. 24.
Auburn runs the ball, trying to get the ball going inside, not able to. And that's going to be punting down.
Yep, got to punt it. There's just nothing there. They brought number 24 off the edge. It looked like he was going to do it from the other side. He just did it from this side, and he got in on the play.
Bear Alexander, one of the guys in there, also in to make the play. It was Kamari Wilson, the DB, five-star commit, and this is where things can get interesting.
Kick it deep left.
Kick it away from eight. Sean Miller, the returner. Punt is going to hit short, and Miller's going to take it, and he's going to cut to the near side. Nice open field tackle there, and it will be first down IMG. Sean Miller on the return.
All right, they get the ball on about the 40-yard line.
So here's what it – if I had to guess what IMG decided to do, defensive adjustments. We're going to play press, and we're going to stack the box. Offensive adjustments, probably going to be to run the ball.
Well, and they can press. They're good enough to do that, and when they stack the box against press man, you got to come back with rub routes and things where the defenders start running at each other, because I don't think they're good enough to switch and stuff like that.
Two receivers to the near side along with an up-back jet motion, and now it's inside zone handoff. Auburn hit him at the line of scrimmage and able to stack it. Going to be a gain of about one or two on the play. Second down and long coming up.
Yeah, they gave some motion. Looked like some eye candy type stuff, like they may throw a bubble or something. And I don't know, that may have been an option for them, but they ended up giving it on the inside zone. And
normally when you do that, the quarterback and the mesh point, the eyes are with the bubble action. The bubble action was away from the mesh point right there.
Yep, it was strange. Like I said, just eye candy, just things are a little bit different. Looks like they're going to be in a twin open set with two backs in the backfield this time.
This looks like a pass set.
Spread out.
Roll out. And knocked down by Coleman Granberry. Good thing.
No, no, he wasn't open. I mean, really, because the safety had him, and then when he saw the ball throw, he broke off. Okay. Yeah, because I was looking at the receivers. Yeah, what Scott was saying, he saw an inside receiver ran a flag route or a corner route, and they threw it to the short guy. But when he threw the ball, the safety was
broke.
On top of it.
Yeah.
And then when he threw it, he broke. And, you know, they didn't have anything on that corner. Same formation. Twins up top, split at the bottom, a gun split.
Heck, they might run the same play, see if they can get that matchup again. The running backs are up.
Looks like we're bringing edge pressure or some kind of pressure here.
Auburn drops off. Powell coming around the edge. Want the post route,
overthrown.
And it's going to be punting time here for IMG.
Good pressure on the quarterback. Yeah. And more than just Powell. I think we had two or three guys coming in there. Let's see the replay here. Yeah.
Braden, good push up the middle. And the other thing is as good as these receivers are, if a DB's in the area, you make a throw kind of have to be on the money.
Well, you know, you can throw these deep ball routes, but if we got a guy that can run with you, then it's a 50-50 ball. The crossing routes, the dig routes and stuff like that are harder to defend.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't know if they're going to – and plus, that's right in the quarterback's line of view. Oh, fake it.
To Duffy. No. High punt. Auburn needs to get away from it. And it's going to roll out of bounds. He was looking at the out route.
I'll let you describe this because I was watching this back.
I was watching the – so Duffy is the punter, and it looked like for the life of him he wanted to throw the out route. And Auburn covered it well enough, and then the last second he punted it away. Auburn High is going to get it at about the 30-yard line.
30, 31, somewhere around there. Oh, we need a ball.
That's always frustrating, trying to get a ball. Auburn gets a stop.
Now, hey, let's give the little ball boy some credit. He already had the ball out
there. He was ready to go, yeah.
But he already had it. He was saying, well, I'll take the other one if you want me to. And he took off. Then they realized they got the ball.
No runs there for one, a first down run, and then two passes there for IMG.
Yeah, that's a good job by the defense.
Here comes motion by Auburn. To bubble to the near side.
Ooh,
hello.
Wee.
Hello.
That was an inside linebacker off the bubble. There's nobody to block him.
Nope.
You gotta trust your play fake to stop him. He never even looked. He took straight off. There's nobody blocking him. I think we got to the line of scrimmage. That was about it. Second 10.
Jordan Hall, a four-star linebacker there, flowed really well on the inside inside.
He shows he has a little bit of speed.
Yeah, that was impressive play there. Second down and 12. Press coverage once again across the board for IMG. Pittman drops back and gets sacked. I think he wanted the screen. And unfortunately, Malik Bryant came through a little bit too easy there.
Yeah, there was nobody open. Nobody was open as far as downfield goes.
I think it was a screen, though. That was the problem.
Well, what they did, they took the guy that had press man on the inside receiver up top of the field.
Yeah.
He was lined up in press man, but just before the snap, he buzzed in and blitzed, and the safety took him man-to-man.
Yeah.
So instead of being two-man, it was cover one, basically.
And whatever Pittman saw, he didn't like, and he had to eat it. Third down and 12 coming.
Oh, no, it's more than third and 12, brother.
Sorry, third and 23 coming. There goes motion now. Pittman underneath to Etheridge, and Auburn High School was about a block away from getting good yardage. I don't know if they would have got the first.
Well, the safety was all – whoever came up, I don't know, outside linebacker, whoever it was, linebacker. But he was on it. Etheridge caught the ball and got hit for no gain. Fourth down and very long yardage. We got a punt.
Yeah, that was a senior DB, Kona Northwestern. And that's a big stand there by IMG.
Well, but let's bear in mind, we've held them. They've held us. We're giving them the ball back.
It's going to be illegal substitution.
Well, but it ain't going to make much difference.
No.
It's still going to be fourth down and forever.
Yep. Fourth down.
So that'll make it fourth down at about 18, 17.
Got to have a good punt here.
Yeah, a good punt not going to this guy.
Got to have a high punt, got to cover it.
Come on.
High kick. Fumble on the ball on the ground. We'll see who comes up with it. I think IMG had the first guy on it. We'll see what happens in the mad scramble underneath.
You know, he looked like he wanted to give a fair catch. Oh, IMG
got it.
He looked like he wanted to give a fair catch signal. He put his hand briefly, but then didn't keep it up. And, you know, we almost had a chance to get another break.
That was one of those. It feels like that was the type of play in the first half that Auburn got.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of the backs got it.
We'll see what IMG does now.
Close but no cigar. All right, come on,
defense. Same two-back set here for IMG. This time the backs are even with the quarterback. They're not in front of them. I think that means run. Duffy claps his hand. Little inside count, little inside zone there. Bounces off a tackler, carrying another guy. Gain of about five or six.
Just a counteraction right there. Just counteraction to the big romper stomper, the big heavy back.
Allen. The kid's going to Penn State. He's a good quality running back.
Boy, he stays behind his pads, got good balance. But it, it has some pretty decent blocking that time against our left side of our defense.
6:37 and counting left to go here in the third quarter. Auburn leads 17-13 over IMG.
All right, need a break. All right, now let's get these tackles in there.
Empty set here for IMG. 4 seconds on the play clock. Duffy claps the hands, calls for it, and
hold it.
And
come on,
wants
the
over the middle pick. Trey Elms looking for the flyer out, not there. Tigers come up with the interception. You can keep the hold. We'll take the pick. Tigers ball.
Yeah, but they were holding the heck out
bad,
of us.
Yes.
Two of our guys. I saw two of our guys going down in grasp. But hey, I'll take the pick, like you said.
Jamias Pitts came through. He won, got held. Powell got held as well. No call, doesn't matter. Tigers ball from the 19.
Well, they were going for the home run, and, we had good coverage. And he actually was a bad throw. I don't know where he was throwing the ball.
Yeah, he threw it up to no man's land.
He threw it up for grabs, and only problem is the wrong guy went after it.
Yep. 6:11 left to go. Tigers take over.
They're still in that press, man, with edge pressure.
Inside run, and Auburn, and now the issue right now that Auburn's running into is the D-line is swallowing up the offensive lineman. Auburn can't get to the second level with their blockers.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. You can't allow that push.
Right.
Because the guard's trying to wrap around and get involved in that, zone, ISO zone, whatever you want to call it play, where the guard's wrapping around trying to get up on linebacker. He can't get around the block because the nose of the center's getting stalemated.
Gain of about two on the play.
All right, they're not impressed, man. They don't like this formation.
They don't like the tight look. Inside handoff, breaking a tackle. Fights hard, gets about three or four, sets up a third down and short, third down at about four. Just a little inside zone here for
– Look how they're just coming flying in there. I mean, it's – maybe time for another screen. Of course, it's third and four, but, hey, I don't know. They've been closing so fast on those screens lately.
This team is fast. And that was the issue there on the edge pressure. Marcellus Josephson had the block, but the guy was in press coverage and then just shot inside to try to make the play on the inside zone.
All right, motion. They're not in man this time if they are.
Well, if they are, the safety rocked over. Run the out route right here to Bakari. Inside zone?
Nothing.
Got to go forward. Can't bounce out against this group.
Well, he was trying to be patient, but the we got kind of stalemated right there on our left side. But, we had some initial movement, but didn't maintain that contact, and nose guard slipped off.
Auburn's going to have to punt. Yeah, this is just the group that you cannot bounce it against. It's just they're – nothing good is going to happen unless you're trying to run it outside.
Yeah, and I've been surprised IMG hadn't tried to go outside more.
Right.
But, we've shown a propensity to be good against outside runs this year.
Right.
But they've had a little success early and hadn't come back to it.
Tigers will punt. Miller will take it. Looks to return it. Makes one guy miss. Block in the back. There's the call. Nice tackle made. And it'll be 10 yards back from that spot, and an Auburn player is down. And it's Clark Cleveland who gets up. There's going to be a clip on the play, so move it back even more.
So that's going to put the ball.
So I do know this. If I'm the Auburn coaching staff and I see that IMG is looking to jump over the personal protectors, if you go up and hit them, it's actually a penalty on IMG.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a penalty on them for leaving the ground like that.
Hey, go take the 15.
All right, ball's on the 32. We got 3 minutes and 49 seconds to go in the third quarter. Auburn's up 17-13 over IMG.
Defensive battle here in the third quarter. IMG with a little bit of motion, and it's an inside zone. Allen running hard. He's been their best player. On the offensive side, Allen has been very, very good. Gain of 8 on the play as we see some rain start to come down.
Yeah, this back is pretty strong. I think the other back, number 3, I think it is, he's faster. But this old boy, he's got good eyes, and he gets upfield in a hurry.
Inside zone once again, running hard. First down yardage across the 50-yard line. First down.
Same play as before.
Yeah.
Just ran it again.
I think after another turnover by the quarterback, this might be a, all right, run the darn ball.
Well, you know, the thing is, they got plenty of time. Get the score, get ahead. That's what I'd be thinking. If I had this kind of football team, I'd be thinking, all right, let's just run the ball. Let's just score, get ahead. Then we can start milking the clock. Of course, running the ball milks the clock.
Yep. A.J. Duffy, the quarterback for IMG, claps of hands. They got an early start. It's going to be – looked like it was going to be a tackle for loss. That is one heck of an effort there by Katron Allen to take it.
That was a buck sweep, and he just went where the guard left from. He just filled it, came right off the guard's butt.
Three guys hit Allen in the backfield, and he ends up getting two.
Yeah.
He's good.
He's strong. Gun split again, two backs in the backfield with a quarterback.
2:17 and counting left to go here in the third. Auburn up 17-13. Claps of hands, inside counter once again. Allen bounces off of one guy, gain of about 2. Third down and about 6.
You know, early in the game, he was breaking those tackles. Yeah. Now we're holding on to him. You know, we're getting more hats to the ball as well. We're getting more people to the ball. But, you know, you're realizing this is a strong puppy. We got to hold on. You can't let him go. He's a man.
Third down and about 5, 1:44 and counting here in the third. Tigers leading by 4. IMG has the ball in Auburn territory. Two receivers to each side for Guffey.
A little bit movement.
Yeah, and they're gonna stop it. His left tackle got an early start, and they will blow it dead. What you don't like about that, if you're either coach, official was slow. He immediately said false start, but you got to run in there, slow it down, get, because I mean, don't need anything late happening because you're late on the call. 3rd and 10 coming. .75 penalty yards for IMG. Two receivers to the top, solo receiver to the near side.
What they've got is a tight slot off the tackle with one receiver, and the other ones are twins on the other side.
Up back to the near side. Guffey drops back, looks to run. Yeah. Tigers sack him. Punting time for IMG.
Yeah, number 26 did a good job of getting pressure. Powell Gordon came off the edge. Forced the quarterback to step up and then step left, and the linebacker got him along with Power. They both double-teamed and got a half a sack each.
Powell pushed up. Clark Cleveland comes up for the sack along with Powell.
Big set of downs right there. Big set of downs. No scores in the third quarter so far, and it's 17-13 Auburn.
Snap it over the punter's head. 30 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. Bakari Daly back deep for Auburn High School. He's got one good return. Something was not to the liking of Auburn High School, and Auburn High has to call timeout. 20.8 seconds left to go. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Auburn leads 17-13. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
Hello, this is Coley Trent.
Oh.
Auburn High School leads by a score of 17-13 against IMG. And everybody on IMG just pointed to somebody different. I think they were trying to get Auburn to jump off sides. Snap is back. Auburn almost gets it. It's an end-over-end punt that's going to hit, and Auburn needs to get away. The roll is IMG. It'll be touched down at about the 15-yard line with 7.9 left to go here. We'll hold it here for this last play of the third quarter.
And you know, I can see it now. There's just a little light mist coming down. It's not raining. You just have to say it's a mist. I mean, you'd barely put up an umbrella. There's a few umbrellas out, but it's just a mist. You can barely see it, but it's coming down.
Yep.
And if you want to throw the ball, that's a disadvantage.
You're right.
Wet field, sloppy field is an offensive advantage, especially if they throw. But once it starts raining, it's a little bit harder.
Brad Harper into the game at running back. Pittman, your quarterback. And runs it right up the middle. Brad puts his foot in the ground.
Love it. 5 yards.
5-6 yards, and that's going to do it. Who'd have thought we would be here at the start of the game? Auburn High School goes to the fourth quarter with a lead of 17-13. We'll be right back in 1 minute. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
Whether you're a senior golfer or pro athlete, high school football player, or little league superstar, injuries are sometimes just part of the game. When it happens, it's nice to know the Orthopedic Clinic is here to get you back in action. The team of physicians at the Orthopedic Clinic offer the latest in treatment, procedure options, and complete rehabilitation for knees, hips, ankles, spine, and more. Don't let aches and sprains or more serious orthopedic issues keep you on the sideline. Visit theorthoclinic.com and schedule an appointment today.
Let's talk about saving you money. Four Seasons Federal Credit Union has auto loan rates as low as 1.9% APR and back-to-school loan rates as low as 7.9% APR. If you live, work, worship, or attend school in Lee County, you can join in person or online at apply.fourseasonsfcu.com. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Opportunity Lender, subject to membership and credit approval, limitations and exclusions apply. Ask for details.
Classic Hits and Auburn High School Football. Wings
94-3. I thought you was going to make me take up the battle there.
All right. Second down and six here for Auburn High.
Little inside handoff.
Nothing
there. It's going to bring up third down and about three or four.
Just inside zone, two tight ends, and then two wide outs to the same side toward Auburn sideline. But they just stuffed it.
Third down, four.
Rain starts to come down a little bit harder right now. Third down.
Third and four.
Yep. 11:38 and counting left to go here. Auburn High School has liked this two tight end set.
Two tight ends with two flankers.
Yeah.
Different words for that, different names. I used to call it ace.
Right.
I don't know what other people call it nowadays. Now they switched out, got to a bunch to the Auburn sideline with a tight, no, unbalanced.
It's the unbalanced look. Inside handoff to Harper. Harper puts his foot in the ground, gets his first.
Got it. Got the first down. Great job. Great run up the side. I was kind of anticipating to try to, you know, do something off tackle. They run right up the gut back to the nub side, just zone back to the nub side.
Yeah.
Good call.
Nice run there by Brad Harper. First and 10, 11 minutes even left to go here in the fourth quarter. As if you're watching on YouTube, it looks pretty bad live. It's again, just that heavy, steady mist. Auburn pulls two. Nice patience there by the running back.
Good.
He's going to run his way past the 30 to about the 33. Brad Harper, the starting middle linebacker, with a nice run, brings up second down and short.
Yeah, and he showed a lot of patience, too.
Yeah.
You could see him kind of wait, and just then scoot off the block and get the extra yardage. That's a big play right there, first down.
25 seconds left to go here on the play clock. 10-20 and counting. High school trying to get the formation right.
Take your time. We got all the time in the world.
Well, you got 10 seconds
on the
plate.
10 seconds left on the clock. You got to eat up every second.
Harper moves to the right.
They snap that with about 2 seconds.
Inside handoff. Harper lowers his head and tries to get what he can. Going to get about a yard. Brings up a third down and about one or two.
Number one, Brad Harper, off right tackle.
Yeah, we didn't get much out of that one.
Stop made by number 12, Daylon.
9:44 left to go here. Third down and short.
And this seems to be the formation we've had the most success with right here. Two tight ends, two flankers.
Auburn High goes hard count. Not there. Bear look. Or at just a 3-4 with the outside backers walked up.
No, I think it is actually a bear. They both covered on both guards, so they're in bear. Good play call. Oh!
Ball's loose. IMG has it.
There's a fumble on the play.
I'm going to tell you, we had a play. That's the best thing you can run against the Bear defense is a counter trap. And we had it, and it just literally popped out of his hands. Nobody hit him.
Slipped out of Brad's hands.
They caught it in the air, and we tackled him. Great field position for IMG now on the 26.
IMG takes over at the 26. Brad is a starting middle linebacker, and just when he went to go make the move, ball came loose right into the IMG player's hand. But first massive, like really big hurt mistake there that Auburn High has made here. Yeah. You had the pick in the first half. This one is different. Tiger crowd comes to life, trying to get this defense, trying to spark this defense. As I got to imagine, IMG's got to run the ball here. Guffey in the gun, claps of hands, inside zone. And Auburn High does a good job of stuffing up the lanes. Gain of about one on the play, second down and nine.
Right. 9 minutes to go into the fourth in the game.
Nine minutes left to go in regulation.
Ball's on the 25.
Tigers up by four. Threatening is IMG. Two receivers to each side. Allen, the running back, he's going to motion out. And it's a little screen look thrown behind him. It's going to be incomplete. Incomplete. The ball was ruled to be thrown forward. Third down and eight coming. Coach, the yards per carry for IMG is very, very high, but it seems like if you win first down, they go off script in a hurry.
They get off script, and plus, they're not used to this. They're behind in the fourth quarter. Have been that way all year, and so they're off script totally. This is out of character for them, and it's raining. Misty, but raining.
Big third down here. Three by one set, three receivers to the left side, the wide side of the field for IMG. Auburn showing pressure. Guffey has it, drops back, looks over the middle of the field. Where's the flag? There it is.
Good call. We hit him a little early. I mean, it was bad.
Pogue had the play red. He got there early, though.
Well, he went for the hit and knocked the ball. If he goes for the ball, we got a chance. He went for the hit. It's going to give him a first down. That's unfortunate. Because it was a great break on the ball, but he broke to the man instead of breaking to the ball. And that's a big down. See, he wasn't even going for the ball. If he'd gone for the ball, he might have had a chance. You got to see the ball thrown, especially when you're on top of the play.
What are we doing here? It's third and nine from the 25-yard line. Pass interference against Auburn. It's a first down. The issue there, if Polk sees the ball, he's going to go up and be able to knock it down.
Hey, you know, he had a funny angle, so he probably couldn't have picked it, but he could have knocked it down.
If
he'd have made a play for the ball, then that's
if you go up to try
call.
To catch it, then maybe
it's
you
a
get the call.
Call. But
he just ran smack
no
into
doubt.
Him.
He went for the hit.
Two back set here for IMG. Little counter trap right up the middle. Auburn does a good job of getting initial pressure, and then Allen continues to run his legs and gets help from his friends, and it's going to be a gain of eight on the play, and Auburn High is bringing in any and everybody they can. Avery Ferris comes into the game. E.J. Harris coming into the game. Auburn going big.
Hey, you know what? There ain't nothing fancy about that. Just straight at you. Just keep your feet moving. Everybody stay up. Don't go down and keep your feet moving.
Auburn High is trying to get as big as they can right here. Stretch to the outside. And Allen lowers his head, gets the first down, first and goal from the two.
Just a buck sweep. I mean, there's nothing fancy. It's just a plain old buck sweep. But we hit him right at the line of scrimmage, but he just runs. It's just a one-on-one tackle, and you're not going to, you know.
It's going to be hard to tackle him at contact when you hit them at the shoulder pads. You're going to have to hit them low.
You got to get it. But you hit him low.
Yeah.
Might not get him.
Offset eye formation here for IMG. And it's just a counter right up the middle. First down, touchdown, IMG. As IMG cashes in the turnover.
Yep. Oh, gosh. Gave him a short field.
Yep. First time Auburn's done that, really.
This year.
Yeah. I mean, it's something Auburn really hasn't done.
Number 10, James Fielding to attempt the extra point kick.
All right, boys, let's don't let this take the heart. We had some things going offensively. Let's don't let that take our heart out. Let's just keep going. I mean, we're not even down the field. We blocked this kick.
Now it's a two-point game. Tigers do it again. Block it again.
Right over the –
he jumps over – I don't know if that's legal.
He doesn't jump over a body. He jumps over
the gap.
He jumps over the gap. The guard should take that down. He doesn't do it. He jumps over a gap, not a man. You can do that.
So now Auburn –
he literally put both hands on the center and the guard and just kind of – like you'd – you know.
Yeah.
What do you call it when you hop over and use your hands?
Leapfrog.
So now we're field goal from winning the ball game.
You're down by two. You block two extra points. Yeah, it was guard center and Brad Harper just right there.
What do you call it when you put the hands on his back and jump over?
Leapfrog.
Leapfrog. He leapfrogged, but he used two different people to leapfrog.
It would have been nice if Auburn wouldn't have had to score another point to get the win, but Auburn's going to have to score another point to get the win. Down by two now, 7:25 left to go here in the ballgame. IMG will approach and kick it away. It's going to be a touchback, and Auburn will take over at the 20-yard line. Got an answer.
I mean, yeah. We had something when they got in that bear. We had something. We had the play you got to run. The best play against that is the counter trap, and that's exactly what we ran.
And just the ball.
And had something. And the ball, I mean, literally
ball just squirted out.
It just came out.
Yeah,
nobody hit it.
He had two hands on the ball, and just the ball came out.
I guess it was a little damp from this mist, and it just popped out.
Auburn in a four-receiver set. Williams moves to the right. Pittman claps the hands.
They're in press man again.
Pittman trying to get out of it. You're right. No pressure.
Pittman stuck for a loss by number five, Malik Bryant.
Pressure and everybody was covered up.
Well, they're in press man. They went. Let's just face it. We're not quick enough to get off the press man. So, you got to find something where, like I said, maybe the receivers could start crossing.
Auburn tried to cross there and couldn't get it.
They were crossing as they were going downfield. You got to do it immediately. That's the only way you got a chance.
Auburn tries a little pin and pull action here.
Too much penetration over the three technique. Yep.
And it's going to be a gain of about two or three. Third down coming up.
Yeah, the left defensive tackle over the three technique. He got too much. He got some push there. Avery Ferris is having to come out with a shoulder.
3 yards down, third down, 12.
Avery's had a shoulder injury last second half of the year. Charles Reese will have to check in. Third on a big third down.
Third and 12.
2x2 set here for Auburn. Here comes motion. Drops back his
Pittman. There he is right there.
Wanting the wheel route. And just a little bit overthrew him was Pittman looking for Davion, DV. And I'll tell you this.
He wouldn't have gotten a catch.
The safeties on IMG, not only do they close, they go low.
Yeah.
That's we saw Auburn High do that a lot the last couple of years. But, one way to avoid hitting somebody high and getting any targeting penalties, take out the legs.
Yeah, but you got to get there at an exact time. If you don't, you can't do that because you'll miss the tackle. But if you get there at perfect time when he's trying to catch a ball, he's basically a defenseless player. But instead of hitting him in the in the helmet, you're hitting him in the legs.
Fair catch taken, and IMG will have it at the 47-yard line. 5:50 left to go. Auburn's got to get a stop here. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
WGZZ, Waverly, Auburn, Opelika, a broadcast service of Auburn Network Incorporated. Your Auburn High School football station. Wings 94.3.
I think we need it. 5:50 left to go here, and as you heard when we came back, I think Auburn need to find a way to flip momentum right now. As right now the momentum is with IMG, and Auburn needs to stop, and I think they need to flip momentum with a turnover. Scott Bagwell here, joined by Coach Robert Maddox. Little jet motion here, but it's just eye candy for an inside zone. And Allen makes one guy miss, and then second guy there gets a tackle, gain of about six on the play.
Actually, this is the buck sweep.
Yeah, with the zone just to.
Like I said, that's a big youngin' there running the ball. Second down and about four.
IMG with about 160 rushing yards.
Which is probably well below their norm.
They haven't been able to really throw it here tonight.
We're packing the box.
Got to force them to throw it. Second down and about five. Split flow action. Allen lowers his head and going to leave himself short. Big collision right there between him and Brad Harper. Third down and one.
Allen off left tackle. Stop made by number one, Brad Harper.
Yeah, that's a good hit by Brad. He's probably playing inspired right now after what happened. Yeah. Third down and less than a yard.
4:48 and counting left to go here in the fourth quarter. Auburn down by two.
I would bet money they're going to run the ball.
Yeah.
And probably 13 is going to get it running straight at us.
Auburn high, zero high look, trying to
Buck
crash
sweep.
The box. Buck sweep. Allen makes through two guys miss, and then finally into the secondary. Trey Nelms makes the tackle to the 32, gain of 12, first down.
You know, I want to say something. I've seen it on both sides. I've seen IMG do it. I've seen Auburn High kids do it, just helping each other up. It's been a clean game. I've seen a little bit of yakking and a little bit of hot dog action, but not much.
Right. This is a game with no playoff standings or anything like that on the line where you go out there and you compete. Auburn High showing blitz. And now we'll change, and Auburn High will change up what blitz they have called.
Right
inside handoff. Auburn High does a good job of getting some penetration there.
Right up the middle.
Little to nothing on the play. Second down and long. Mark Tolan came through. Powell Gordon also able to get in there. 3:35 and counting left to go here in the fourth. Tigers need a stop.
Second and 10.
Boy, strip, scoop, score would be great.
Yeah, because it's 3 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the game. 17 to Auburn's at 17, IMG not 19.
Claps the hand. And again, that counter tray up the middle.
Oh.
Allen breaks two tackles, bouncing it outside. First down yardage, and now carrying Auburn defenders to about the 15.
Yeah, he just open field, stiffed arm, defensive back. Shows you why he's going to Division One.
Yeah, he's going to Penn State, and he's been very good, very, very good. Auburn High, Coleman Granberry almost got there, almost got the play. Now he's limping
number
off.
Number two, Kaz Dooley, along with number four, Nasir Poe. First down, IMG.
I think he just got dead leg there. IMG looking to score a touchdown and almost put this one away. 3 minutes left to go here. Up by 2 points is IMG.
Two backs in the backfield.
Inside handoff, almost like, again, that triple option look, gain of about two or three on the play.
And they have run that, and like you said, they have run that and come out with an option off of it. I'd almost wish they'd do that instead of running that
big hand of the ball off to 13.
Big 13 up the gut now. He's a load. Auburn switching people out on both sides on defense.
Auburn's first line is gassed.
And they should be. I mean, they played their hearts out. They played their hearts out tonight. 2 minutes and 24 down to 20 seconds. 2:20.
That shouldn't have been a 40-second play clock. It should have been a 25. There was a stoppage, and it should have been reset to 25. 2:12 and counting left to go. 20 seconds left to go on the play clock. And IMG is milking it for everything they're worth, which they should.
Yeah, absolutely.
Seven seconds left to go. Guffey claps. Auburn tries to get a jump on it. Allen puts his foot in the ground. Oh, they switch it up to Gage now.
Yeah, that's the fast. That's the fast. That's the first time he's been in that I've noticed.
He's been in there to block. He has not been in there to carry the ball.
Yeah, this guy has a lot. Number three, he's got a lot of balance. He's a guy that just can make a cut on a dime and accelerate out of it. Almost a dead stop, be full speed, two steps.
Third and one.
Third down one from the five.
1:26 and counting. IMG taking their time. 13 seconds left to go here. Auburn High has two timeouts. IMG has three. 7 seconds left to go on the play clock. IMG doesn't look overly sure what they want to do. 2-1. Ooh. Just got it off. They want an inside zone. Auburn High stacks them up. Call your timeout. It's fourth down. Auburn calls their timeout. 56.4 left to go here. Fourth down and about two, maybe one.
Think about this. Dog, you don't even want to go there. We don't fumble the ball.
I know.
Who knows?
Who knows?
If a frog had wings, it wouldn't bump its back legs every time he jumped.
I see you changed the phrase.
Yeah. You thought I was going to say the other day. I've had a lot of practice. I've had a lot of years of experience.
Auburn High School calls a timeout. They have one more. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Tigers down by two. It's a fourth down coming up. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network, presented by the Orthopedic Clinic. No representation.
Ball is spotted at the 6-yard line. Fourth down, one.
Inside handoff, IMG is going to get the first down, going to get the touchdown.
13,
that
seals it up.
We'll do it. Well, if you're able to block the PAT, it's still a one-score game. It's
this
only an eight-point game right now. Allen plunges it in from about 4 yards out.
Well, it's a no-brainer. You got to go for it on fourth down. You don't kick a field goal. Field goal don't mean nothing anyway.
Right.
A field goal would not help you except get you out of field goal range. But they've had two blocked right up the gut. And I'm sure they've made the corrections. You would think they have, but I remember a punt, Bama punt about 50 years ago. They didn't make no corrections, and Auburn ended up winning the game by a freak margin.
Yeah, no, and IMG not trusting their field goal is going
They're
to
going
go for
two.
Two.
I don't blame them. Plus, that'll put the game out of reach.
Yeah. Auburn High brings pressure. Gage bounces outside and gets in, and that will push it to a 10-point game, 27-17, and that's going to make things awfully hard for Auburn.
If you would have told me it was going to be this kind of game, that Auburn would lead almost the entire game until about the last 4 or 5 minutes of the game, I'd said, hey, but still lose, that would be a plus, all things considered.
Auburn played their guts out.
Played their hearts out. I'm so proud of these guys. I'm proud of these coaches. They had a good plan, did a good job. They got nothing to hang their heads about.
The only other – I mean, and if this game ends at 10 points, the only team – it was a 24-14 game a couple of weeks ago for IMG against a prep school out of Connecticut that has 19-year-olds. It's a post-grad school. This is a high school team here in Auburn, Alabama, that took IMG Academy – and went nose-to-nose with them.
And, you know, these kids are going to always live. We almost had them.
We had a
shot.
Now what you do is.
But you can build on this. You can take this and build. This is a great springboard into the playoffs.
Here you go. You had an opportunity. You've proven what you can do. Now you just got to go do it in the playoffs. And that kickoff will be taken at about the 1 yard line. Yancey coming up the middle, makes the guy miss, tries to get outside, and going to get to the 22, 25, and pushed out of bounds at about, and there's going to be a late flag.
Number seven, Carson Yancey on return.
And could be good field position here for Auburn.
I don't think that was a vicious thing. It was just.
It was late.
It was late. He's clearly in the white, and the flag was right. But I don't think it was a vicious thing.
No.
You know, it was just the intensity of the moment.
41.7 left to go here. Auburn High School down by 10. Two scores late. That's another one that was close to the end zone. And that's a bunch of starters.
See, that's not much right there.
It's also a bunch of defensive starters on that kick cover group for IMG.
Yeah. Well, they got 40-something kids out.
They got 41 kids on the roster.
All right, got a flag for something.
It's a pre-snap penalty.
It's either they are offsides or we're an illegal procedure or something.
Everybody's walking to the sideline. Is it a timeout?
IMG may have called timeout. I don't know. They're writing something down. They haven't signaled
anything.
Timeout IMG. That is their first call timeout of the half.
IMG calls their first timeout of the half. 27-17. Tigers had a turnover in the fourth quarter that gave IMG the lead, and then a fourth down conversion for a touchdown for IMG to give them this 27-17 lead. Auburn High School scored first. They came back after falling down 13-10, took the lead at 17-13, held that lead through the third quarter into the fourth quarter, and just couldn't find enough offense in the second half against what is going to be the best defense that Auburn High will play this year. But also, you know, it gives you, hey, we need to make sure we have answers for this, and this. I don't think you're going to face a team who's going to go press man all the way across the board.
Well, that's the difference. I mean, I think Central Phoenix City's defensive front's the same as in this caliber here, but their secondary is not like these guys.
Pittman drops back, looking for some help, and he's going to be sacked. Timeout called by Auburn.
13, Clyde Pittman, stopped for a
loss by number
19. Well, the thing you didn't want to do is throw up a Hail Mary and let these great athletes at IMG, you know, break on the ball, because their safeties are deep. They're just saying, throw it, we're going to break on it. They'll have a big advantage.
I think what Auburn was looking for there was, I mean, Clyde obviously trying to make a play, and he's going to come off the game now. And the other thing is you got to be realistic here. 33 seconds left to go.
Down
by 10. You don't want to get anybody hurt.
All right, we got a timeout.
We'll be back. After that last timeout, I don't trust them. 33.1 left to go here. Auburn High School has played their guts out here tonight, and they're going to come up just short.
Bottom of the fifth, the score remains. The Atlanta Braves 1, the Houston Astros 0.
Let's look at some scores brought to you by Franklin Tire and Auto. Friendly service from Franklin on East University Drive across from CC's Pizza in Auburn. 23-14, Prattville over Bob Jones in the second half. 14-13, Dothan over McGill Tulin. Theodore still up big on Mary Montgomery. And in the fourth, the Braves still lead the Astros 1-0. Those scores brought to you by Franklin Tire and Auto. Friendly service from Franklin on East University Drive across from CC's Pizza. 3-by-1 set here for the Tigers. Second down to 19. Harsin, your quarterback. And he gets destroyed on a defensive end that just ended up winning.
Stopped for a loss by 19. That's Dominic James.
Tigers are trying to get set up and run one more play.
They could have maybe got two if we'd hustled up a little bit. This is going to be at 3 seconds.
It's going to be the last play of the game.
2 seconds.
Parson has it, drops back, looking for the out route, has his player, and as Parson's going to throw a complete pass to Marcellus Josephson, and that'll do it here tonight. Auburn High School plays their tail off, and they're going to come up short 27-17. Auburn High School gives IMG everything they wanted and then more, and have nothing to hang their hat about. The only thing you hope is that number 70 down there, Big Avery Ferris, isn't hurt long term.
Yeah, well, you like you said, it's been a nagging thing all year. So, you know, rubbing a little Tiger Balm and see the trainer every day. And
tell him, hey, it's the playoffs.
Get a little treatment.
Yeah.
Suck it up.
Yeah. Auburn High School plays their guts out here, and they come up just a bit short. 27-17, the final score here. Auburn High School falls to IMG. They give the number 2 team in the country everything they wanted and more. We come back, we'll have the post-game show. You're listening to the Auburn High School Sports Network, presented by the Orthopedic Clinic.
Football's